Last example. Find the limit, then use the Epsilon-Delta definition to prove that the limit is actually L. This time we have an absolute value function. We're going to find the limit as x approaches negative 7 of the absolute value of 2x minus 14. So where's my chalk at? Here we go. Well, I got lots of chalk, but the one in the holder. We're going to let x approach negative 7, and that means that we're looking at the absolute value of 2 times negative 7 minus 14. That is going to be the absolute value of negative 28, which of course we know is equal to 28 because the absolute value function tells you how far a number is away from 0 on the number line, even though we just always say it gets rid of the negative. Now, one thing to take a note of as we do our proof is to pay attention to the idea that when we let x approach negative 7, the absolute value signs had to change the sign of our answer because, well, 2 times negative 7 minus 14 came out to be a negative 28. So we had to change the sign to get the limit. And we see the graph is here, and here's our negative 7. And we're approaching that y value, that limit of 28. So again, we're going to say, given that epsilon is greater than 0, that the absolute value of f of x minus l is less than epsilon. Again, assuming that to be true as we work out the relationship between delta and epsilon. So one last time, this is scratch work. This is not the beginning of the proof. So the absolute value, our function, is, again, the absolute value of 2x minus 14 minus the limit that we found, which was 28, is less than epsilon. Okay, well, we have an absolute value inside of an absolute value, and how are we going to get this expression to look like, oh, yes, let's change these notes. Well, I really meant to write x minus c there, but I was going to change it into terms of this problem anyway. Find delta greater than 0 such that f of x minus 28, the limit that we found it to be and we're trying to prove that it is less than epsilon whenever 0 is less than the absolute value of x minus a negative 7, or effectively just x plus 7, is less than delta. So how do we get this expression with an absolute value symbol in it to look like just simply x plus 7? Well, this is just right already where we need to take into account the idea that what happened, what did the absolute value symbol do when we tried to find the limit as x approached negative 7? It changed the sign and made, you know, negative 28 basically be positive 28. Well, what math notation do we use, or what math operation can we use to change a sign other than just, well, it's not the same as absolute value symbol, of course, but if you want to make a negative number into a positive, you multiply it by negative 1. So understanding that as x approaches negative 7, that this is going to be a negative answer, that 2x minus 14 is going to be, okay, I'll write that a better later, less than 0, that absolute value is going to change the sign of that expression or that answer. So we can replace the set of absolute value symbols with a set of negative parentheses. So the absolute value, you know, not all the time, but just for this particular problem with x approaching negative 7, we have the absolute value of the negative parentheses 2x minus 14 less than or minus 28 is less than epsilon. Distribute the negative through, and we get the absolute value of negative 2x. That's going to be negative times negative is positive. I'm not sure why I'm pausing there. Plus 14 minus 28 is less than epsilon. Now we have the absolute value of negative 2x minus 14 is less than epsilon. This is going to be the absolute value of negative 2 times the absolute value of x plus 7, because negative 2 divided by negative 2 is 1, and negative 14 divided by negative 2 is positive 7 is less than epsilon. This is going to be the absolute value of negative 2 is 2, so we have, bringing that over to the other side, we have, I just want to make sure I don't run out of room here, the absolute value of x plus 7 is less than epsilon over 2. So we have basically x plus 7 is less than delta. We have x plus 7 is less than epsilon. Really, understanding how to deal with that absolute value symbol. Now, if we were finding the limit as x approached, I don't know, 5 or 6 or 7, or somewhere to the right of that sharp bend where the absolute value sign function didn't have to change the sign of that value, then we would just drop those absolute value symbols altogether. But in this case, we needed the negative parentheses. And dealing with that, we get right off the bat a nice direct relationship between delta and epsilon, a little bit easier than it was in our previous example dealing with the quadratics. So we're going to let delta not D, but delta equal epsilon over 2. And now we are ready to start our proof. So the proof is for every I know I'm going to have to cram this in here. Epsilon greater than 0, let delta equal epsilon over 2, and 0 is less than the absolute value of x minus negative 7, which is less than delta. And I have the statement up here, but I really don't want to have this start to flow, and I hate proofs that kind of go all over the place. So let me step off, erase all of this, and clean it up, and put this proof statement at the top of the board. That's better. I wanted to have all this on the board so you could pause it at the end and see everything together. So again, our proof: for every epsilon greater than 0, let delta equal epsilon over 2, and 0 be less than the absolute value of x, basically plus 7, which is then less than delta. And with those conditions, again, we're trying to, whenever these conditions are met, that the absolute value, we're trying to prove that the absolute value of f of x minus l is less than epsilon. So let's start off with that one last time. Absolute value of f of x is less than l. That is equal to the absolute value of 2x minus 14. Minus our limit that we found to be positive 28. That is going to be equal to, just look very similar to this work over here, or over there, the absolute value of negative 2x minus 14 minus 28. That is equal to the absolute value of negative 2x. Distributing the negative, we have, again, positive 14 minus 28 is negative 14. Factoring out that negative 2 and writing the absolute value of negative 2 is not just completely factoring out, but separating this one absolute value statement into two absolute value statements. The absolute value of negative 2 times the absolute value of x plus 7, or x minus a negative 7. Now the absolute value of negative 2 is equal to positive 2, and the absolute value of x plus 7, we showed that the absolute value of x plus 7 was, where is it at? Oh, right here. The absolute value of x plus 7 is less than delta. So, So this expression, this absolute value of f of x minus l is equal to this, and this is less than the absolute value, if you want to leave that in there for a second, the absolute value of negative 2 times delta, because x plus 7 is less than delta. So when I replace that absolute value of x plus 7 with delta, well, that is less than delta, so this entire expression is less than absolute value of negative 2 plus times delta. Okay, so now at any rate, the absolute value of negative 2 is, of course, just 2, and delta, we found that direct relationship between delta and epsilon to be delta is equal to epsilon over 2. And like before, thankfully, these values of 10, or in this case 2, or whatever it was in the previous examples, we're canceling everything out until we get just an epsilon. And we're right back to, thankfully, again, finishing our proof and validating the statement that we found, that the limit as x approaches negative 7 of absolute value of 2x minus 14 is 28, because with these conditions in this proof, we have that the absolute value of f of x minus l is indeed less than epsilon when we have the 0 is less than the absolute value of x plus 7, which is less than delta, and that delta has this relationship with epsilon, which is it's going to be half of whatever epsilon is. So by definition, we have the limit, I'm just going to write what I said a second ago, as x approaches negative 7 of the absolute value of 2x minus 14 is indeed equal to 28. And that is the end of my last third example. I'm Mr. Taru. Go do your homework.